he was in jail for 8 years.
That's my favorite rapper. Drug me 2.5.
Please keep this, please.
Oh, I absolutely am. Then, matter of fact, this is gonna be the little entrance to the video. Going well, but what I have been learning is that, like, you know, there are some people who like get lucky and just get a lot of subscribers right off the bat, but most of the time you gotta post like several videos consistently for a while.
Do tags still work? Like, do tags get you more like?
For sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've noticed that, like, on videos where I actually like pay attention to like what I tag and what time I post and like even down to like what I put in my title and what I put in my description box.
Yeah.
It all, like, the algorithm counts into effect, like into the, all that into the little equation or whatever. So it'd be so much. It's so much on YouTube. Like, I understand why it's a job. Like, it's just a lot. And then my account not even monetized. So it's like, and once you get monetized, you have to abide by a certain set of, like, rules and regulations. Like, every time I post a video. Yeah, like, every time I post a video, I have to make sure that the music isn't, like, copyrighted, because then I have a copyright claim, and that's fine for the purpose of the video being up, but I won't ever be able to monetize it. There's a copyright claim on it. Like, it'd be stuff like, it was something as simple as one time I had a copyright claim on one of my videos because in the video I was cleaning and there was a song playing in the background.
Yeah.
And it was like, copyright claim. Like, it's cool,
so
you can have the song.
How do people find out that you're using their song?
YouTube has some sort of formula, I guess, where like whenever you upload a video, it checks your video.
Wow.
To make sure there aren't any copyright claims. So it'll let you know, like, pretty quickly whether you have one or not.
Yeah.
And then that's the whole other thing with trying to find music for the video that doesn't have any copyright on it.
Wow.
Child, it's a lot. Say hi, Michaela.
Hey. Happy graduation to me.
Thinking. I'm gonna be eating like a heathen tonight.
Hey, how much y'all bet?
Yep, $20. It's okay.
I'm on. It's a very heated discussion. I've been making donations to you like a night away. Whoa, it's not even been 5 minutes since I started recording. I thought it had been like 10 minutes.
I was singing it to the camera. Was you recording you?
I'm not sure.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm so sorry. When, singing into the camera when?
Those spicy LA songs that make you recording us.
So, I'm so sorry. I'm not sure. I have to go back and watch. I'm weak. Yeah,
say recording at the end.
Yeah, it'll say record. You see the red record right now?
The thing was closed.
Oh. I'm not sure. Like, it could still be flipped in this way, you just can't see it. So, I don't know. I love old dirt. Ain't he from Chicago?
What's crazy is,
I just got into King Von.
My cousin, thank you. My cousin on my mom's side is Dirk's baby daddy. Baby mama.
Wow.
So, like, she did years for him.
Like, in jail?
She out now. But she don't work and do nothing. Like, he take care of her.
Absolutely.
But yeah, so like that's
crazy.
Yeah.
Oh wow, what an interesting life. I just would. I'm sorry, but I'm not going to jail for no nigga. I can't do it ever in life. sorry.
You know what jail is like.
I'm okay not knowing what jail is like. Yeah. I'm really okay with that. Like, I don't care how bad it gets, bro. I'm so sorry, but it won't be me.
Ever,
I'm not that one.
If it's ever me or you, it's always going to be.
Always. Every single time. We could be married. It's still going to be you. I'm sorry. But I'm not going to jail for anybody. I might go to jail for my brother.
Okay, yeah. I can see family.
No, I'm not doing it. You will not see me in anybody's jailhouse.
No. Does he already have a record? Like, are they gonna come down on him really hard? Like, what's the
right? The my thing is, I don't care what the situation is. I'm not going to jail. I don't want to know what it's like. I don't care if it's a warrant out for your arrest for some parking tickets. I'm not going to jail. I'm not built for that.
Where you from?
The country. Alabama.
I gotta stay with the Alabamians.
Yeah. Well, no. Just no, because it's some of the. It's
You telling me.
The black parts of Alabama are actually pretty hood.
You telling me you talking to a man? He might have a.
There's nothing he can say that's gonna make this.
Nothing.
I don't write no letters.
That's what I'm saying. Like I'm so sorry, but. Nothing that happens is going to make me be like, I think I'm going to go to jail for this man.
No.
There won't be anything ever in life.
I don't know. You don't really drink like that, but you can get in here.
Every time I see, I follow Keisha Kaur on Instagram. Every time I see her post Gucci, I just be like, dang, she really waited on. He was in jail for like 8 years.
No, he was in jail for 3.
I thought he was in jail for 8 years.
That's my favorite rapper. I charged him 2.5.
Please keep this, please.
I absolutely am. Then, matter of fact, this gonna be the little entrance to the video.
Please, like, that's gotta be the preview. That's
absolutely, absolutely.
2.5. He got high for good baby.
I'm crying.
Oh my gosh.
Uh-oh.
Oh my gosh.
So 2.5.
Yeah, damn.
So then where was he at the other 6 years he was out of the music game?
No, he never left the music game. You tripping.
Well, I mean, but like.
When was he ever not relevant?
I didn't say he wasn't relevant.
You feel like after like Lemonade and all that, he disappeared?
Huh?
You feel like after like Lemonade and all that, he disappeared?
No, not disappeared. I wouldn't even say he disappeared. It was just a period of time where he wasn't making music. And I thought that was because he was in jail all the years. And then he came back.
Hey, Genesis, you listen to radio a lot, right?
No.
You don't listen to radio? See, Gucci is what you call an underground rapper. So if you don't listen to mixtapes, you don't follow Gucci.
Wait, what are we talking about?
She said Gucci was out of music for like 6 years.
Gucci won't. I was underground at that point.
He wasn't. Before Gucci went to jail, he was already big. Like,
yeah.
Was he?
Yeah,
he wasn't considered. I mean, I get what you're saying.
I don't think he was considered.
I get what you're saying.
Gucci got locked up September 2013.
Okay.
He got out in May 2016.
No, Gucci had went to jail before that, though.
No, he didn't. Because you gotta understand something. Gucci popped Young Dolph, the Migos, and Young Thug at the same time. And he belonged with. He got locked up September 2013. It's the reason why I know that for a fact.
Wait, but when did Lemonade
came out?
I could have swore Gucci was in jail when I was in like middle school.
Nah, Gucci got locked up 2013. When he went on the Breakfast Club and they asked him about Nicki Minaj and French Montana, that was at the top of 2013.
But they also don't make music for the same people.
You gotta understand. He called himself the Trap God. The Trap God mixtape dropped October 17, 2012. Trap God 2 dropped June 2013. He got locked up September.
I didn't know this.
That's my favorite rapper.
Oh, Gucci.
Yeah. That's my favorite rapper.
One of my favorite rappers. I feel like that said it all.
I thought that nigga was like this.
What else you know?
Right.
Nothing else. I'm stuck.
A whole lot of stuff. You ain't have
Right, that was a lot of information for me to say.
Yeah. Right. This is it. The coats don't hit like this.
I'm going to tell you, when you step away from music, Jesus stepped away from music.
He married to the Chinese lady?
Yeah, he married to Gina May.
Jeannie,
the girl from the Today Show. Jeannie.
No. The Today Show.
Whatever she is, there was a movie.
The real.
Whatever it is.
The Today Show.
Hell no, because I didn't know they was, he was at that specific place getting cookies for his mama.
Somebody inside.
Yeah, for sure.
That sounds like, it's like not, I'm just going to get cookies for my family, like, and go back to the house. Like,
it's not going to take long.
That's what you would think.
That's what I'm saying. Why, there's no way anybody would have known that it, besides his close people.
And ain't nobody riding through the hood like, devil dog calling me pull over and shit.
Because he's not just riding through nobody hood like
trying
that.
To locate him. Like, every day.
Right. And his car is bulletproof.
You talking about Dolph?
They ain't found the people yet?
They shot him in his car, outside his car.
No, he was shot outside his car.
He was at the little cookie store.
Yeah, we know.
His body was inside the store.
Yeah, he was inside the store. This is what happened. He was inside the store, and this is how I know it was a setup too, because he was the only one in there. Because the people by and didn't even go in the store. They shot at him from outside. So the glass shattered, all of that. It wasn't nobody else in the store when he was in there.
What?
He was the only one in that store that died.
And even the people who worked there, well, none of them conveniently.
Exactly. Conveniently, nobody was hurt. Nobody was killed but him. Everybody, the people that worked there, you know, unscathed.
So they said, like, the owners, like, have conflicting stories. Like, one owner, like, or one worker said, like, this, and then somebody saying something else. But
it's
nobody
crazy.
There. See it when it happened.
No, I thought he was in his car.
No, he was inside the store and they drove by and shot it up.
Girl, it was a whole TikTok.
He had the same situation Nipsey had.
Yeah.
A week before he got the shot, the dude got signed to him.
Wow.
It's crazy.
But nobody's been caught.
That man been coming back to Memphis all that time. He just the first time they ever got touched.
Yeah.
Come on now. 9 times out of 10, when you get murdered, it's somebody that's supposed to kill you.
Absolutely. Like 95% of murder victims knew their killer.
They knew their killer.
They know their killer.
They knew about it. They know at least.
That's why folks with money got shot, but back to the hood.
I mean, that same car.
Got told.
Like, all these people are getting killed when they go back home.
Shootout.
Yeah. Right.
Wow.
Because now that makes you think you threatened the killer.
They didn't ask that.
This was a scheme.
Yeah. This was a plot.
But when you rich like that, if you really making that much money, you're not paying attention to all this shit.
No. That's why I can't understand for the life of me that man, that football player that killed that lady in that car. Henry Ruggs. Sir, why are you even driving? Why you don't have nobody
Henry
else
Ruggs
driving?
Had no money. He was a rookie.
But still, he's in the NFL. And he was... Wasn't he a first round pick?
How old are you?
He was going like over 100 miles an hour.
24,
like
why?
45.
Henry Ruggs was like 19, 20, fresh out of Alabama. When you 19, 20.
Oh, no. This is not if he knows right or wrong. That's not what this is. Because at 19, you know right or wrong. You know going 115
Listen,
and a 55 is wrong.
You can't judge the same people that when you were 19 based off somebody else in 19.
Okay, well, regardless, everybody knows that going 156 miles per hour anywhere in the United States is a crime. And not only is it a crime, you'll go to jail for reckless endangerment.
Right, check this out. So let me tell you something about Alabama. Alabama has been.
You're gonna tell me about Alabama?
Has been.
Did she just say she's from
the college? has been on probation since 1926 because they pay their players. Matter of fact, you don't even got to go to class when you play football for Alabama.
That's like half division. That's like most Division I schools.
No. Alabama is different.
I'm telling you what I know.
They stay on probation. Most people go to Alabama just to go to the NFL.
Yeah,
y'all remember Dominic Wilkins, right?
Dominic Wilkins was one of the best basketball players.
I worked at the school that his granddaughter
That man one of the greatest ball players of all time.
You said Zion Williams?
No, Dominic Wilkins.
Dominic Wilkins.
Oh, yeah.
He can't read.
You over got a third grade education. Herschel Walker, he had a third grade education.
Yes.
And he made it all the way to the NFL with a third grade education.
So riddle me this. Did he or did he not have a license at the time?
He might have had a license and they gave it to him. Just
no, 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 no. Did he have a license?
Wait. The DMV don't work like college athletics do. I know that system. I know pushing kids through to win a game. I know that system. The DMV don't work like that.
Now, DMV is different. You're right.
You gotta pass the test.
Nothing to gain.
Now, DMV, you gotta be competent, motor skills enough, because you gotta actually go to DMV. You're right. You gotta be competent enough. But just because you can drive a car don't mean you can be successful.
Yeah, I see it too. I ain't never said
that. Your motor skills
might be sweet. That's not what's being debated here. Whether or not him being able to drive a car and him passing the test.
Someone thought him safe enough to give him a license so that he could be able to drive.
That has nothing to do with his level of education.
I don't know where Henry Ruggs is from. He might be from Louisiana, Mississippi.
You don't know how to play space. You told us. Come on, girl, what's wrong with you? Why you don't want to play? You still don't get it?
I will say, watching somebody play is really hard. Like, having it explained to you is like, easily digestible. Because otherwise, you can see,
people throw some cards out. But it's actually a very simple concept.
Yeah, very easy.
As long as you can count.
I'm ready now. Okay. Up and down that pole, I still got my money. I'm still got my money. I'm ready. Up to it. Down to it. Okay. Down to it.
$400 or $500 tail.
Go ahead.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
You done did it.
Yeah, you're right.
So you were sitting here telling me you'd have spent $100 on a fifth of crime.
Yes, he already told you.
You ain't talking money, he don't want to talk.
I don't want to. I don't
listen,
want
he said $400 tab. He had that
what he said. He said what he said.
He said what he said.
He heard what he said.
He said it with confidence.
That shit wild to me.
So he only got to say it once.
That shit wild to me.
But we don't know what it's like to have that kind of money.
It's for a good reason.
Huh?
Yeah, and
this is
I don't know what
it's
like
to have
that kind of
money. I do, and I'm not about to spend that type of money on no goddamn section.
It ain't your money.
Right. Yeah. It's your place. That's the bottom line. That's the bottom line.
It's not the logic of it. It's the occasion.
Absolutely.
Like, I don't want to rent out somewhere to go have a party, but if it's a lot of people coming, I'm around the house.
Yeah.
Well, I'm just saying, right, with that night, I think now that you should have came to me with.
Okay. Well, it ain't too late.
I'm just saying, anything to do with drinking and music around here and more atmosphere.
Yeah,
that's what base what you're paying for.
Yeah, uh-huh. Yeah. You're paying for the experience.
Yeah. As long as I got, me a driver that can get me back where I'm going, I don't care.
That's right. That's it.
Yeah, logic.
That's listen.
Cause I ain't gonna drive.
Yeah,
I'm gonna have that lined up first.
You're right. That's gotta be taken care of.
So I mean, okay, I'll see tomorrow. If it's still available,
just let me know.
Checking in the morning.
Is this a nice club?
Mm-hmm. It's my birthday.
Adora. Yes, we're at the graduation, honey. Hi, Mo. So nice.
It's a store.
Ooh, let me open this program, Jesus. Yes, come on, on camera. Come on, let's have help counts. Let's go, my kids.
Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We are delighted to welcome you to Allen Arena and also to the December commencement for the 131st session from Lipscomb University.
Come on, education specialist. My mama got that. That's, I don't know. I would love that. Or even the maroon. All right, what Michaela gonna be?
Master of Arts in Christian Ministry.
Yes, girl! Yes, Michaela, look at her. That's a walk for the people. It is. That is indeed a walk. That's beautiful. That's beautiful. What do you even do with the kilt and all? Kilt and all.
Alexandria.
You got it, Mo?
Yeah. Everyone ready?
Look at us. Whose aunties and family are we? Everyone, get your voices ready for your uwu. Get it ready for the uwu.
Oh, yeah.
Seema Patel.
Oh, they tried to beat us.
They did. They didn't. They not ready, though.
Javid Kenya.
Mm-hmm. Make sure ain't nothing in your way, daughter.
Courtney Reagan.
All right, y'all, here we go.
Michaela Pena.
Good job.
Absolutely. We was
Good job, team. Good job, team. I think that was successful. That was successful.
Really got that guy.
Absolutely, absolutely. I had to drag the ooh out. I had to drag it out. I'm sorry.
Bouncing on 24. It's the remix to Ignition. Hot and fresh out the kitchen. So what's the plan then? Can we establish the plan?
Playing games.
Okay, got it. So we don't. Okay.
But for now, we take another shot.
It's the way it's built. Okay, that's fine. Okay.
Yeah, I know that's right.
Honor. Sing, Sabrina. Sing, Donna. Yay. Sing, Autumn. This is prime footage right here. Yeah. Yay! Sing for the people. Michaela, you singing on camera. You singing on camera, Michaela. Sing. Michaela, you was on camera. Michaela, you was on camera.
Y'all ain't see us singing?
You was on. No, she was on camera. I was recording her. She was giving a performance. I was trying to let her know she was on camera this time.
I didn't even know what you were talking about.
Oh, sorry.
Y'all suck.
Play a good one.
Good idea.
Good idea.
Good idea. Why I'm zooming in and out like that? Weak at myself. Shot. Okay. Of what? Is there any more dark anything? There's no more Jack Daniels.
I know. That makes me sad.
That makes me very sad. Where's the crown?
We drank it all yesterday.
I had. It was two bottles of crown.
We drank two bottles of crown yesterday. One time I poured six.
If that's all that's left, we got to get a dark bottle. We got to get another bottle.
I poured at least 12 shots. That almost did it. I poured 12 shots at one time for all of us. We drank 2 bottles of Crown yesterday. I don't know if we should be proud of it, but
we should not. That's not good. That's not good. Yes, absolutely. It's been a long semester. We needed those 2 bottles of Crown. Help us, Baba. But we don't have no more. I think that's it. I think that's all that's left. So I'm gonna grab this while we're still here.
Look, can we take a shot for the vlog?
We absolutely can. I gotta set the camera up in a good position. Here, we're gonna set it up here. We are. We've been vlogging this whole time, Larry. I know, but you own the vlog already. You can't take camera time from other people.
I'm taking camera time.
But Larry,
you're not. We have Latoya Robinson. Latoya Robinson.
That's it. Who won the last movie? Larry, but this will be out.
At some point. You look right at me.
Uh-huh, what?
Who's this?
one. Taking care of me. You think I've been. She made a drink.
We got drunk, got drunk.
No, she thinks I'm cool. She gave me a wink, a wink back. And then I think that.
It is. T-Pain gave us so many vibes. He gave us so many vibes.
You gotta give the people another T-Pain song.
Just give us a second. What happened? Okay, don't do that.
Sorry, sorry.
It was like a connection issue.
Yeah, it wasn't us. We swear.
We gotta give the people another T-Pain song.
What's another one?
Hey. Buy you a drink. Buy you a drink.
I'm pretty sure that's next.
That's next?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, okay, good. After that, you can go to another one. Yeah. Come on, Akon? I'll drink that bottle, be my bar, baby. From a distance, looking like a goddamn star, baby.
Oh, the vlog is back. The vlog is back.
What?
The vlog is back.
Vibe is what?
The vlog is back.
Yeah, the vlog is out.
Do it for the vine.
I ain't gonna do it. Why not? Why not? Screaming at myself.